Welcome back. In this part of the course, I'm going to step through how you can install Docker. Now, because this is an introductory level course, we're going to stick with a simple method of installing the Docker platform. We're going to use Docker Desktop. Now, Docker Desktop installs both the client and server components of the Docker Engine platform. So this means the Docker D software, which actually controls containers running on the Docker host as well as the Docker client. And specifically, it installs both a command line and graphical user interface client. So to install the Docker Desktop, go ahead and go to the docker.com URL. On the main page here, you can click on Download Docker Desktop. Now, there are installation versions for Windows, Linux, and macOS, both Intel and Apple Silicon versions. In my case, I'm using Apple Silicon, so I'm going to go ahead and click to download a package which is correct for my machine. Once that's downloaded, you need to go ahead and open that installation package, and this part will be specific to the type of architecture you're using. In the case of macOS, I'll need to drag the Docker Desktop application into my Applications folder. For Windows, you'll just need to go ahead and run the installation. This completely depends on which operating system you're using, so just go ahead and follow the instructions. Once that's installed, if you do see a service agreement, then go ahead and accept to continue. Depending on the operating system, you might be required to authenticate to give the installation admin permissions. In the case of macOS, I need to enter my user password and click OK. And at this point, the Docker Desktop installation has been completed. Once installed, it should look something like this. If you do see any mention of a tutorial, go ahead and skip it, because this course will be stepping through all of the ways in which you can interact with Docker. Now, at this point, you should see the main Docker Desktop dashboard. It should look similar to what you're seeing on screen now. At this point, though, we need to make sure that we can interact with the Docker engine. So to do that, go ahead and open either a command prompt or a terminal, and we're just going to verify that we can interact with the software. So type Docker and press Enter. And make sure you see an output from the Docker command, and make sure there are no errors listed. It should look similar to what you see on screen now. Next, run Docker space version, and make sure you see an output similar to that that's on screen. For each of the components, it should show a version number. Don't worry if the versions are slightly different to what you see on screen. All we need to make sure of is that you do see this output. And at this point, we've successfully installed Docker Desktop, which has installed Docker D, which is the server-side component that manages containers, as well as a command line and graphical client, which we can use to interact with Docker. At this point, though, that's everything I wanted to demonstrate. So when you're ready, go ahead and move on to the next part of the course.